This week on The Wire, budget to boost housing market, new credit laws allow extra $70,000 and business conditions improve. G'day guys, my name is Tim Guest and welcome to The Wire, the week in real estate where you can get all the top stories happening this week in finance, real estate, investment and more. Now please like, comment and share this video, and if it's your first time tuning in, don't forget to follow or subscribe wherever you are seeing this. So let's kick it off this week with our top story, budget to boost housing market. So the housing market will be greatly boosted by this week's federal budget, with Treasurer Josh Frydenberg announcing $507 billion in tax cuts, cash payments and wage subsidies to drive business investment and create jobs. The Treasurer unveiled a $74 billion jobs and tax stimulus plan, including tax cuts of up to almost $3,000 for 11 million Australians, $200 a week wage subsidies for young workers and almost $35 billion in business tax breaks. Frydenberg says the recovery plan will rebuild the Australian economy and secure Australia's future. Business and industry groups and universities roundly endorse the package. And PIPA Chairman Peter Koulizos says there's plenty of good news for real estate consumers in the federal budget. The job creation initiatives and tax cuts announced will support the property market, including helping young people not only stay in their rental properties, but also move into home ownership, he says. The additional 10,000 places in the first home loan deposit scheme will enable more prospective home buyers to achieve their home ownership dreams. And now for our next story, new credit laws allow extra $70,000. So home loan customers may be able to borrow up to an extra $70,000 under changes to the consumer credit laws, says Canstar Group Executive of Financial Services, Steve Mickenbecker. The changes would see banks revert to a more relaxed approach to living expenses when assessing a loan. There would also be less paperwork, speeding up the time it takes to have a loan approved. Based on an average income of $80,000 a year and a 20% deposit, a residential property buyer could potentially borrow $510,000 rather than $440,000, says Mickenbecker. During the Hain inquiry into the finance sector, the banks were castigated for their methods in assessing a client's ability to repay a loan, relying on simplified approaches rather than thorough investigation. The latest changes are designed to protect consumers against taking on a debt they cannot afford while providing credit into the economy at this critical time. The changes would put upward pressure on house prices by creating more demand. And now guys, for our final story of the week, business conditions improve. So business conditions improved in September, recording an increase in the areas of trading up 6 index points, profitability up 2 index points, and employment up 8 index points. And that's according to the September NAB Monthly Business Survey. The increased confidence is built on the gains of last month and is now well above the trough in March after the pandemic hit. Conditions are now above average in WA, SA and Queensland, pointing to an ongoing recovery in those states. And though New South Wales remains negative, it also improved in the month. The report says confidence rose in most industries in the month, though the gains in retail and recreational and personal services were marginal, and finance, business and property services was unchanged in the month. Confidence is now neutral or positive in all industries except retail and the services industry, personal and recreation and finance, business and property services. Well guys, they're the top stories for the week. Now please don't forget to like, comment and share this video and follow or subscribe wherever you're seeing this. Have a great week and remember guys, there's only one thing in life that makes a difference, and that's action. Thanks a lot, and bye for now.